It was a scheduling loss, even if the Miami Heat refused to make such concessions. Even if Jimmy Butler refused to make such a concession. Dropping to 0-4 on the second nights of back-to-back sets, and despite Butler scoring 37, the Heat fell 112-93 Wednesday night to the Boston Celtics at TD Garden. With seemingly only Butler able to maintain his legs at the close of the three-game trip, the Heat moved to an early 11-point lead, fell behind by 16, closed within 5, but ultimately and expectedly ran out of gas. The loss came with assistant coach Dan Craig filling in for Eric Spoelstra, who left Boston earlier in the day for the birth of his second son. Most read Heat coverage Winderman's view, Celtics 112, Heat 93. The Celtics, idle since Sunday, remained undefeated at home, fueled by 31 points from Jaylen Brown, 28 from Kemba Walker and 19 from Jason Tatum. For the Heat, also undefeated at home, there now is the refuge of their first extended homestand of the season, a four-game run that opens Friday night at American Airlines Arena against the Washington Wizards. The Heat have not played more than two consecutive home games to this juncture. 5 degrees of heat from Wednesday's game. 1. End of the road, what does it look like to close out a season opening run of 13 of 21 on the road? It looks like the Celtics closing out the second quarter with a 26-7 surge to take a 52-44 lead. It looks like the Celtics aggressively working for 18 first-half free throws to 1 for the Heat. It looks like the Heat reverting to previous bad habits, with 10 first-half turnovers. 2. The free throws, the Heat's second trip to the line did not come until Butler worked his way there for 2 shots with 4:48 left in the third period. Boston was up to 15 of 20 from the line by that stage, with 4 Celtics at that juncture having attempted more foul shots than the Heat. 3. Still pushing, a night after becoming the 10th Heat player to record a triple-double and then taking over in overtime in Toronto, Butler single-handedly attempted to keep the Heat within striking distance, with 26 points by the end of the third quarter. Even with a flat jumper that seemingly barely clears the height of the rim at any points, Butler stood a 4 of 5 on three-pointers in the third period, closing with a career-high 6, on 10 attempts. It was his 7th career game with at least 5. The 37 points were Butler's high as a member of the Heat. Most read Heat coverage Heat coach Eric Spoelstra returns to Miami for birth of second son. 4. Back to misery. 4 of the Heat's 6 losses have now come on the second nights of back-to-back sets, with each of these first 4 back-to-backs ending on a road against teams with winning records. This one came in the wake of previous such losses to the Minnesota Timberwolves, Los Angeles Lakers and Philadelphia 76ers. Craig going in said it would take our best version of us to end the trend. The loss came after the Heat moved to 4-0 on the first nights of such sets with Tuesday night's victory in Toronto. It doesn't get any easier, with the Heat's next back-to-back set in a week, with a home game against the Lakers followed by a road game against the resurgent Dallas Mavericks. 5. Homecoming moment, the coaching opportunity brought Craig back close to where he was raised in Massachusetts. I moved when I was 12 years old to Mass. I went to high school here, Craig said. Not a whole lot of coming to the games here. But obviously grew up here as a fan, and locally. But now I'm with the Heat, so 17 years, that's in my blood. Craig, a basketball player at Chelmsford, Massachusetts, high school and at Plymouth, NH, State University, already had planned to have family and friends in attendance. It worked out pretty funny, he said. Craig did get one victory Wednesday, when he won a coach's challenge that overturned a fourth-quarter charging call on Butler.